Hello and welcome to my breaking news segment from Los Angeles about news that's happening from the European Parliament by people who live in London. Anyway, the European Union has just appointed the next heads of the important folk in the Commission. And it's one of those things where it's like, yep, it isn't very democratic. And so Anne Widdecombe, the lady in the Southwest who represents me in that parliament, decided to take to her microphone and give them a piece of her mind.
May I say that I, if I needed any convincing at all, that the best thing for Britain is to leave here as soon as possible. It was the way that those elections were conducted yesterday. Because if that is this place's idea of democracy, then that is a serious betrayal of every country that is represented here. Because it is not democratic at all. And that is just one of many reasons why Britain is right to be leaving this place, hopefully, on Halloween.
Okay, she's not wrong, and I suppose it is right to be morally indignant about this, but there is something about this that's rather amusing, and not in necessarily the way that is positive to Anne Widdecombe.
And it is right because there is a pattern consistent throughout history of oppressed people turning on the oppressors.
Oh, God. Oppressed people turning on their oppressors. Right, okay. Oh, Jesus Christ. Oh, God. They're going to say that Britain was being oppressed by the EU.
Slaves against their owners.
Fuck!
The peasantry against the feudal barons.
Fuck.
Colonies, Mr. Verhofstadt, against their empires.
Oh, Jesus,
and
Anne.
That is why Britain is leaving. And it doesn't matter which language you use, we are going and we are glad to be going. I represent the southwest of the United Kingdom.
Piano, facciamo concludere.
And I found on my Grazie. Very first day that this place has decided, at least this place hasn't, the powers that be have decided to actually increase the size of fishermen's meshes, thereby reducing their income by 40%. That's what you do here. That's why we're going.
Grazie,
news
conclude.
And long, wir gehen, we're off.
Really, Anne, that was all over the increase of the size of the fishermen's nets. Oh, Jesus Christ. Whose idea was it to put the boomers in charge? I can't stop laughing. I just can't believe that Anne Widdecombe actually stood up and told them that Britain was the slave of the European Union. I mean, where's the lie? But it basically slavery. Look, right? I'm totally in favour of the Brexit by going there and fucking up the EU, right? But possibly saying that Britain, the second biggest contributor to the European Union, is the slave of the European Union because the size of the nets has been increased by 40%? Possibly not the most persuasive argument for people who aren't invested in the narrative. The sort of regular person who's just looking at that thinking, what? I'm being oppressed by the European Union because of fishing net sizes. Basically slavery. And then all the BBC have to do is just quote her. I mean, it is genuinely magical. Brexit Party MEP Anne Widdecombe has been criticised for comparing the UK leaving the EU to, quote, slaves rising up against their owners. Like, I love the sentiment, Anne, but I don't think the average person really thinks that's the case. I mean, I'm totally behind it. I really am. I'm just like, yeah, those fucking enslaving Germans and French have been enslaving the British for thousands of years, probably. But does the man on the street think that? Is the regular person who's just walking around pushing a pram thinking, I'm being enslaved by the EU? I mean, all I'm saying is perhaps this was a little far. If anything, I think she would have actually been stronger focusing on the European Union's own method of selecting the next president of the Commission and various other high points in it, because that does seem to have been actually a really corrupt process. And nailing the EU on this sort of corruption and cronyism especially in a particular ideological direction, would have been undeniable. Even the BBC has to say that critics of the selection process say that the European Parliament's own contest for the main job, the Spitzenkandidaten, the lead candidate process, was ignored, and that four of the main jobs went to Western Europeans with no nominees from Eastern Europe. The old boys club is always going to be the old boys club because all of these structures are maintained by networks of people who know each other and have connections and can rely on one another to do something productive for the other person when something needs to be done. And you can only do that with people that you know. So it always ends up this way. So this is the inevitable corruption of the system, basically. And so you can argue that a much bigger and more corrupt system becomes increasingly more corrupt, especially when they're not directly accountable to any demos, as you can see in the behaviour of Jean-Claude Juncker. These people are terrible. Or, of course, you can say that we're the slaves of the Europeans and need to break our chains, which is about where David Lammy decided to weigh in. Fuck. David Lammy. Anne Widdecombe just compared Britain leaving the European Union to slaves rising up against their slave owners. It is impossible to explain how offensive and ahistorical it is for you to equate my ancestors tearing off their chains with your small-minded nationalist project. Shame on you. On the plus side, it seems that Anne Widdecombe's hysterical position, and I hate to have to say it, right? I'm not saying the EU isn't an evil entity, because it is. It should be destroyed. But I agree, it's not quite the same thing. I mean, we did vote to join it, it changed and became increasingly corrupt, and then we voted to leave it, right? I don't want to take away from anything from Anne Widdecombe on this. I don't want to have to criticise her on this. It feels silly having to criticise our own side, but I kind of think you're making us look a little bit ridiculous. The corruption was a much more convincing angle, and we're not the slaves of the European Union, Anne. Damn it, Anne. God damn it. I thought I was the radical here. I thought I was the wild-eyed extremist. You know, God damn it, Anne. I mean, on the plus side, it is kind of amusing how you've managed to get David Lammy to calm down, though. It's just impossible for me to explain why this is so offensive. So I just won't. I won't bother getting offended. I'm just going to say you're a bad person, Anne Widdecombe. My ancestors. But on the plus side, Anne Widdecombe and the Brexit Party doubled the fuck down. Liberal Democrat MEP Martin Horwood called for Miss Widdecombe to withdraw her comments and apologise. Anne Widdecombe has not only embarrassed herself, but she has embarrassed the nation she represents. A little bit. But Miss Widdecombe defended her speech. We are currently part of a political union which makes us subservient to laws made by others in Brussels. It is entirely appropriate to liken this to slavery and servitude. Of course we don't bear shackle marks, but we just ask the good people of Greece how EU-induced poverty and unemployment feels, and you'll quickly find out how their democratic votes were ignored by their real masters in Brussels. Well, that was a good landing. Yes. Good idea to bring out the Greece card. That is actually really good. The BBC have got a tweet by Aaron Banks. The British led the world in abolishing slavery. We have nothing to be ashamed of in regards to David Lammy's response. I'm like, yes. Yes. Do it. Literally do it. The British did nothing wrong. The BBC has included that in their article. This is incredible. And the fact that the Brexit Party isn't backing down is genuinely good. Very impressive, actually, right? I'm very pleased. Oh, God, you're such a bunch of boomers. Like I said, I'm not trying to criticise the Brexit Party because I very much understand why people are voting along this, you know, a single issue party. It's totally, totally understandable. And by God, I hope they get Brexit too. So I'm not even against what they want. It's just, this was a bit much. And that's coming from me, you know? So, just saying.